Good morning. This is Sam. Good morning. We're ready to do the YogaShape Method. This is for all ages and all abilities. Please say hello and let me know if you can hear me. I want to check to make sure that we have the sound working. So this class is for all ages, all abilities. It's a blend of hatha yoga with Pilates moves, a few infused into it. And this is all the poses have been renamed, so they're easy to remember and fun. The goal is to bring yoga and stretching to all. We start in mountain one, where we warm up, and then we go into our sun salutations. Then we go into mountain two, and then we, where we do some traditional yoga poses. And then we finally go into mountain three, where we are warmed up enough to do some deeper poses and hold them a little bit longer, and then our final cool down. So it is only an hour. All you need is a mat and a water bottle. If you have a magic circle or any exercise bands, these are really great. Or if you have some small hand weights, we might add those in. So good morning. Say hi if you're there. Let me know where you're coming from, and let's get started right away. Okay, so let's come to the center of our mats and just have our feet about shoulder width apart. Just have your knees pointing forward, put your hands right on your hip bones and just draw an imaginary line straight down. And let's just start picking our shoulders up and rolling them back as we focus on our breath. Let's inhale through our nose and exhale through our nose, clearing your mind and focusing on your breath. Picking those shoulder blades up and squeezing them back and around. And then let's go the other way. Good morning, everyone. Say hello if you're there. Leave a little emoji. And then let's just roll the shoulders back, drop your head down, and roll it to one side. Inhale, roll. And then roll it to the front, to the other side. Let's do that a few times, just rolling side to side. Let's come back to the center. Let's inhale our arms all the way up to the sky, reaching up and stretching up as high as we can, reaching up to that sky, breathing into this, and then just drop one arm down. Place that hand on your hip and lift up and out of your rib cage. So we're having a nice lateral stretch here on the side. And this beautiful Sunday. And then let's inhale all the way back up and exhale the other arm down and lift up and out of your rib cage. Good morning, if you're there, say hello. You're ready to warm up with YogaShape. Let's inhale all the way up. And then let's swan dive forward, hinging on our hips, arms out to the side, and just slowly bend down, slight bend in your knees until you can drop all the way down. And then just rotate your weight back and forth, shift it back and forth. Drop your head down, shake your head, head and neck is relaxed. Let's just relax those arms. And then let's reach behind and clasp our hands and extend our arms up to the sky. Drop your head down if you can. Straighten your legs and just breathe here. And then let's release our arms down, swooping them down, coming into a sit position. And just sit and breathe here. Look down, shift your weight back a little bit. You should be able to see your big toes. And then let's release back down and reach me up behind and clasp those hands. Let's just flow with that. So let's inhale up. And exhale back down and out. We're inhaling and exhaling through our nose, just warming up gently. Let's just hold here. Try to straighten those legs if you can. Drop your head down. And let's release our arms down. And let's lift one arm up. The other leg is bent. And let's look to the side or straight up. So one leg is bent, one leg is straight. Just gentle twist to the side. And let's switch sides. Inhaling the other arm up. And then let's switch side to side. Let's flow with that. Just do a couple more each side.
let's come back down to the center. Let's reverse swan dive all the way up, coming all the way up into a sit or into a standing position. Slight little back bend here, and let's come down into our heart center. Let's reverse our arms back up to the sky. And swan dive back forward, placing your hands on the mat. And you can walk or hop back or stepping back into downward facing dog. Let's just walk out our dog. So our finger, look up, your fingertips should be flat on the mat and spread apart, pressing into the mat. And just walk out this dog. Our goal, we're trying to get our heels down to the floor, and then let's go press all the way down. And inhale and come up on our toes. Let's roll back down and do that again. Roll back down. And come back up. Great job. And let's just stop here for a moment. Let's just bend our left leg in and try to press your right heel down. And switch sides. And let's release back down. Let's come all the way forward into a plank here, so you can drop to your knees and be flat here. Or you can be right here. Shift your weight a little bit forward and just hold your plank. Let's just do a little micro bend here with our, so just bend and extend. Switching legs, bend and extend. Bend and extend. Just a few, just warming up, saying hello legs. Just a little bend and extend with our legs. And then just hold here. Let's just bend that right leg, bend and extend. Bend and extend. Good job. Pulling your abdominals in. Shift that weight a little bit more forward. And then switch sides. Bend and extend. Bend and extend. Bend and extend. Great job. And lower down to your knees. Let's go into extended child's pose. Sitting to the side for a moment. So all the way down. Trying to bring your heels to your knees. Extending your hands out. Resting your forehead on the mat. Let's just shift our weight to one side. Really stretch that side, really getting a beautiful stretch in here. And go to the other side. And then let's slowly come back up into our, walking into our cat-cow. And we're just gonna be arching our stomach up. Up, pulling up our abdominals up as high as we can. I'm already getting hot, so taking my one shirt off. So we're going to arch up as high as we can into cat-cow. So pulling those abdominals up, arching up here and just holding. And releasing that belly button down. Slight arch here. Don't whip your neck back too far. Just pulling your abdominals in, breathing into. Let's flow with that inhaling up and exhaling out. Inhaling up and exhaling out. Inhaling up and exhaling out. And then let's come back into a neutral spine. Let's drop down all the way to our forearms and stretch up your toes and lift up into dolphin. Try to press those heels lower to the floor. Just breathing into this. And then let's lower down here. We're going to extend a child's pose just for a breath. And then come all the way back up. Let's go to spinal extension. So left arm up, so right leg, lower your hips. We're breathing, balancing, and holding here. And then let's release down and switch sides. Inhale the other arm, the opposite leg up. Lower that hip, spread out those fingers. Your head is parallel with your arm. Toe is pointed, and then let's flow with that. So inhale up, exhale down. Just warming up. One movement with each breath. And then let's hold here at the top. Pull this leg and opposite arm in and extend it back up and out. And then hold here, drop this back leg down and lift it straight up and down. Breathing into this. If you need to drop this arm down, you can. And let's hold here at the top. Drop this arm down with little pulses, pulse, 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 pulse. Leg is straight, just little pulses. And then let's cross this leg over, look back and drop it down, and lift straight up and down. Trying to keep your hips square, your abdominals pulled in nice and tight. And hold here, little pulses, pulse, 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 pulse. And then let's just take this leg, we're doing a little bend and extend. Bend and extend, just a small bend and extend. Bend and extend. So just very small micro movement, we're just bending and extend. And then just hold it there, and then let's come back out to the center here. If you can, bring your arm out, same thing, a little bend and extend. Bend and extend. Breathing into this. Now let's flex our toe and then point it out. So bend it in and point it out. And then let's release down. Let's just switch sides. Inhale the other arm and opposite leg up. Lower that hip down. Head is parallel with your arm. And drop this leg down and lift it straight up and down. And then squeeze and lift up. Counting to yourself. Great job. And then hold here at the top, let's tuck in and extend out. Squeezing in and extending out. And then let's hold there at the top. Drop this arm down if you need to, just a little pulse, pulse, pulse. Small range of motion. And then stop, let's cross this leg over, drop it, look back, drop it down. Then lift straight up and down. Pulling those abdominals in, spreading out those fingers, slight bend in your elbows. You guys look great. Keep those hips squared. And then let's hold here at the top. Let's do a little bend and extend. So just a small micro movement, just bend and extend. Spread the weight out between your arms and shoulders. Down to your hand, your palms, and then hold here. Let's cross this leg back over here, and we'll bend and extend. Abdominals pulled in, so just a very small range of motion, and then flex and point, flex and point, flex and point. And then let's release down. Let's just drop down, extend those arms out, and drop your forehead to the mat. Just stretch out your spine and your neck, arms a little bit, and then let's just slowly come back up. We're going to just lift back up into plank. Shift your weight forward and just hold here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And let's lower down to our knees. Drop into grab and lower all the way down. So once you're here, have your arms really tight in towards your chest. And what I want you to do is just squeeze, roll those shoulders back, press the palms of your feet into the mat, squeeze here and pull. Look at us, we're really squeezing all in here. Just holding this. And then let's just lower down for a moment. And look back up, rolling shoulders back up, and squeezing and holding. You should almost be able to pick your hands up here. But let's pick our hands up right now. Just squeeze that in. And then let's lower down and bring it up one more time. So lower down for a moment. And then let's lift back up, rolling shoulders back, squeezing and lifting up. Palms of those feet press into the mat. Hips engaged, pressing into the floor. And then lower down. Let's press and roll and lift all the way back up into down dog. So press up and roll back into down. We're going to step all the way forward with one foot, and then the other foot, so we're in standing forward fold. Put your clasp your hands to your elbows and just shift side to side. And then let's slowly come back down here, reach behind. Come up into chair, into a sit position, and slowly come all the way up. Reaching behind, let's come back into our heart center. And then let's just check in with yourself. Let's inhale all the way back up. And swan dive forward, hinging at our hips, slowly dropping down back into that standing forward fold. Inhale, look up to monkey. So we're halfway up here, our arms are dangling, we're just in a tabletop. The goal is, so you don't want to be here or down too low, you want to try to have a tabletop here, arms dangling. And then lower back down. Let's press our hop back into down dog. Let's go into a one-legged down dog. Just lift this up. Just bend out here and open up. Do a few little circles one way. And then let's go the other way. And then let's extend this leg back out. Square your hips and pull this up and under out to your left knee, left elbow, and extend it back up. Open up here and just make a few little circles. And go the other way. And then we extend it out and let's tuck back under. So we're trying to bring this knee to the opposite elbow. Let's do that one more time and then we'll switch sides. And then bring it up and under here and hold. Squeezing and holding. And then let's release down. And then let's raise the other leg up. So raise that other leg up and square off your hips a little bit. Breathing into this. And then let's open up those hips. Spread out those fingers. Press your weight into your hands. Make little circles one way. And another way. This should feel good. And then let's come back. Extend that leg back out. And we're going to tuck it up and under. Bring it to the opposite elbow. Making little circles. Oh, this just feels good. You might notice you're tighter on one side and square your hips. Extend that leg. Tuck it under. Bring your knee to elbow. Back up. Open up here. Now, if this is too much, you can just stay in down dog. And then join us for tucking your knee to your elbow. Let's hold here. And then release back out. Go back into that down dog. Drop down to your knees. Let's go to extended child's pose. Forward breath. And let's slowly come back up into a sit position. Let's turn around and come into a sit position on our mats. Now, if you have a band, this is great. I want you to use it. If you don't, that's okay. But if you have a band, let's put it around our legs right now, a couple inches down from our knees. And let's sit up nice and tall on our mat. Let's just make a C curve with our spine and roll down one vertebra at a time until we're all the way here. Inhale, your arms up over your head. Exhale, your arms back down. One more time. And pull your legs in towards your chest. Let's just do a little gentle massage in your low back and sacrum into the mat. And then let's just release down, arms out to the side, just windshield wiper. Legs to either side. This should feel good. And then let's come back to the center, knees to right over your ankles. Inhale, your arms over your head. On the exhale down, make sure you can touch your heels so we adjust. And then let's one vertebra tuck our tailbone under. So squeeze that under, make that curve, pressing your low back into the mat. And then one vertebra at a time, let's lift up off the floor all the way. So low back, mid back, upper back, and just hold here. And then pick your heels up and lower down one vertebra at a time. Lowering that down, trying to be mindful of lowering your back one vertebra at a time down versus just a plunk. Let's do that again. So tuck your spine under, squeeze here, and then squeeze that butt up, but lift up one vertebra at a time if you can. Hold here, and then pick those heels up and be mindful about lowering down the upper back, thoracic spine, mid back, and lower back. Okay, I'm not going to have a band because my band just broke, but that's okay. We can do this without a band. So then we're back to here. Let's inhale and lift, squeezing our glutes all the way up. And then let's lower down, lightly touch. So we're going to do that for 10. So squeeze straight up and down, just activating those glutes, warming up. And then hold here at the top, little pulses, pulse, 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 pulse. Breathing into the really squeeze those glutes. And then hold here, release down and squeeze and lift straight up for 10. 9, really lifting. We're just lightly touching and then lifting. 7, 6, 5, lifting straight up and down. And then holding here at the top, little pulses, pulse, 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 pulse. And then release down and lift, squeeze straight up for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Good job. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold here. Let's bring our knees a little bit closer together. Legs stay out wide. They're not all the way together. They're about an inch apart. And lower down. Lift straight up and down for 10, 9. If you want to put your knees together and it doesn't hurt at all, you can. And then hold here at the top. A little pulses. Pulse, 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 small range of motion. And then lower down, straight up. So we're going for 10 each time. We're trying to do 30 on each one of these. That is the goal. Hold her at the top and little pulses. Working on those gluteus, maximus, the deep six in our butt. Let's hold her at the top and lower down. Lift straight up and down for 10, 9. Keep breathing, squeezing. Make this work for you. And then we're going to alternate, knees out, knees in. So let's hold you at the top, lower down, knees out, and knees in. So let's do a few of these. Lift and squeeze. Squeeze those glutes up. A few more. And hold here at the top. Now lower down for a moment. Just spread your legs out a little bit more, plant them out to the side a little. So your knees are pointing out to the side a little bit. Squeeze all the way up. And just pulse, 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 pulse. We're hitting a different side of our gluteus maximus in the deep six. So pulse, 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 pulse. Really squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Little lifts. Hold there at the top. Little pulses. Pulse, 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 pulse. Good job. Squeeze here at the top. Squeeze, squeeze. You've got this. Hold it. Then lower down. Lightly touch the floor and lift straight up. 1, 2. Let's do 10. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold here at the top, little pulses, really feel that, ooh, getting harder, little pulses, and squeeze here, 4, 3, 2, 1, great job, slowly lower down. Let's bring this left leg in, line it up with your belly button, extend the other leg up and straight. Try to point that toe and keep it straight. And left lift straight up for 10, 9, 8, 7. If this is too much, you can go back to what we were doing before. And then hold here at the top, lower down and switch legs. Extend the other leg up, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and switch sides, 10, 9, 8. Keep this leg toe pointed, leg as straight as you can, hands flat on the mat, and lower down. You guys hear the frog that is joining us? Maybe shake with a big singing frog. Oop, he stopped. And then let's lower down, let's bring those legs in, cross this leg over. Thread the needle, your hand through here, and just press out on your knee. And just pull this in, get a nice gentle stretch here. And switch sides. So thread the needle, pressing your hand out on your leg, and pull in here. Whew. Breathing into this, release down. Inhale your arms up over your head. Exhale down, let's extend one leg out. The other one is bent, bend it in. And use this to gently just roll yourself back up onto the mat. Let's turn around and come all the way onto all fours. We're going to go into our sun salutation. So we're going to prepare for those. We've done about half of one. So let's actually do one. So let's lift all the way back up into down dog. And then let's come forward into our plank. And lowering down into crocodile. So full is here, modified is on your knees. Let's flatten everything behind. Feet flat on the mat. You can come to just here. Squeeze your shoulder blades in so you can come here, or you might lift up or come all the way up to here. Breathing into this, feeling this nice stretch. Now let's just lower back down for a moment. Let's press and lift back up again. Just come up to where you want to go. And just breathe into that. And let's lower back down. Let's do that again. Press and lift all the way up. back down. So now we're going to press and roll back up into our down dog. So pressing up and rolling back into down dog. All the way to deadlift. So you can be in a one-legged down dog here if you want. And then from here, let's bring this leg all the way forward into a nice deep lunge. And then let's step the other foot forward. So we're in standing forward fold. Inhale and come up into monkey with that nice tabletop flat back. Lower back down. And then inhale and come up into that chair or just sit position. Hands either, you could be here, here, or here. And then inhale all the way up. Coming back into our heart center. So we're going to add on to that. We're going to do three more of those. Maybe we're going to do, let's do four of them. We're going to do four. So this is the fastest part of the class, and then we're going to slow it down. So it's one movement with each breath. Remember, you can add in a, you can just do down dog, or you can do a one-legged down dog. You know, it's your practice. You can do what you want. If you're more advanced, by all means, add in a few more things here. But remember to alternate legs. It's more challenging to know if you're alternating, teaching this virtually. So let's come to our center of our mat, shift our weight, find that perfect posture. So sink your neck out. Come up to that nice, perfect posture, shoulders rolled back, pelvis tucked in. So everything is in line with each other. Feet are shoulder width apart. Right now you're in your perfect posture for the day. So I want you to be mindful when you're at home of your posture. So when you're brushing your teeth, are you bent a little bit? Or when you're sitting on the couch, how do you sit? When you're driving your car, how do you sit? When you're washing dishes or doing laundry, start to be mindful of what you do. We all kind of have habits. I know I sit crooked in the car. I'm brushing my teeth, I think crooked. All of these things, the way we move our spine and our body, or if we carry a backpack, remember when we used to carry a backpack with one strap? It affects us cumulatively over the years. So a lot of times the aches and pains and different things that we have going on, we can't explain, we don't know what it is. It is a cumulative effect of 30, 40, 50 years of your body not being in alignment. So the more you're aware of this, better, and the more you can start to take corrective action. And yoga, believe me, is going to let you know where you're strong and where you're not, and it's going to help you get balance and strength and all kinds of great things. Okay, enough of me talking, let's get started. Let's inhale all the way up. Swan diving forward. Let's inhale, look up to monkey. Exhale, back down. Place your hands on the mat. Let's step back with one foot and then the other foot. Going into down dog or one legged down dog. Your choice. From here, let's come all the way forward into plank, full or modified, lowering down to crocodile, coming up into our up dog or full dog, looking back, lowering back down. Let's press and roll and look back up into down dog or a one-legged down dog. From here, let's come all the way forward into one big lunge, step forward and drop down. Inhale, look up to that monkey. Exhale, back down, coming into chair. And then coming all the way up, coming back into your heart center. Three more to go, so come back to the front of your mat. Inhale all the way up. Swan diving forward. Inhale, look up to monkey. Exhale, back down. Step back with one foot and then the other, looking to down dog, or one-legged down dog. Coming forward into plank, full or modified. Dropping down to your knees. Or all the way down, coming up here, going to where you want to go. One movement with each breath. Let's press and lift and roll back into down dog. Or one-legged down dog. Coming all the way forward with one foot, and then the other foot's here standing forward fold. Inhale, look up to monkey. Exhale, back down. Come into chair, and then come all the way up. Coming back into our heart center. We're going to do two more of these, so come back to the front of your mat. Inhale all the way up. Exhale down, swan diving forward, hinging at your hips. Inhale, look up to monkey. Exhale, back down. Step back with one foot, and then the other foot going into a one-legged down dog. Coming forward into plank. So you can be here, or you might be in modified. Dropping down to your knees. Inhale, come all the way up to your up dog. Press, lift, and roll back into down dog or one-legged down dog. Coming all the way forward to your standing forward fold. Inhale, look up to monkey. Exhale, back down. Inhale to chair. Go all the way up. into your heart center. Let's come all the way forward. We're going to do one more of these. And that's our final one. So inhaling up. Squat diving forward. Inhale, look up to monkey. Exhale, back down. Step back with one foot on the other foot down. Dog coming forward into line. Drop into crocodile. Inhale, up dog. Push and roll back into down dog. And coming all the way forward with one foot. And then the other foot stays standing forward fold. Inhale, look up to monkey. Exhale, back down. Inhale to chair. Come all the way up. Coming back into your heart center. So you should be fully warmed up right now.
We just finished our sun salutations. We're going to go into mountain two. If you have water, please grab it. Take a slug. Take a break if you need it at any time. Stay hydrated. I'm outside. It's getting hot out here. So we're going to go into mountain two. We're going to do warrior one, twos, and threes. Today, actually, we're going to do triangles. I know I keep saying we're going to, but we're going to.
So let's do that. So come back to your mat. Let's come into the center of our mat. Come into your heart center. Catch your breath. Let's do three deep breaths together. Go to warrior one, two, reverse warrior, and triangle. So let's step all the way forward, pivot, flatten our back foot, rise up and rotate our shoulders around. Inhale your arms up to the sky, shift your weight forward, arch back a little bit. So you're getting this nice stretch here in your flex, hip flexors and psoas muscle. So you should feel the some days you're going to feel tighter than others. You're going to feel tighter on one side than the other. But with a more continued practice, more consistent, you will start to feel balanced on both sides consistently. So sit down a little bit lower and pull back. Don't let your arms droop here. Try to have them straight across. So we're stretching in four different directions. And then let's reverse into reverse warrior. So slide this arm down your leg. If you're not very flexible in a beginner, you might just be here. So you can go to where you want to. And then let's come over here and go right into this side angle pose. So your arms coming up right over your ear and then right out over your head, lower down into this. And then let's come back up, preparing for triangle. So walk this foot in a little bit, shorten your stance. Inhale, both arms up, and let's just shift to one side. So we, our upper body, both legs are straight, we're just reaching forward like we're grabbing something. Like this, and then let's just tick-tock down. So your hands can either come to your leg, to the floor, to a block. Let's imagine we have a big clock here. And let's wind up this clock. So the other way, just winding up our clock. And then let's open up our clock, stopping at 12. So stacking your shoulders on top of each other, both legs are straight. You might be looking down to the center or up. Breathing into this. And then drop this arm down to the floor, your leg or a block. And let's raise the other arm up to the sky. Reverse triangle. This is great for low back pain. And then let's release down. Let's drop down. Let's go into a crescent lunge. So pick that heel up behind you. Come all the way up to your thigh. Shift your weight forward. Let's come here into our heart center. Let's raise our arms up to the sky. We can arch back a little bit, shift that weight forward a little bit, breathing into this. Bring your hands back into your heart center. You can stay here. You can always drop to your knee if you need to. You can be here. So you can be here or you can be up. We're going to twist this elbow in towards this knee. Going into a twist, shift your weight a little bit more forward, breathing into this. Drop down to our knee. Let's all come back to our center. Find a focal point when you come back. And then let's release down, placing your hands near each other, bringing this leg back into down dog or one-legged down dog. Your choice. Breathing into this. Let's lower down. Let everyone come together into two deep breaths. And let's step all the way forward. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Pivot and flatten your back foot. And let's rise up. And rotate our shoulders out and around. Bring it to warrior one. So arms out tall. Lunge into this. Arch back. Glance down and make sure you can see your big toe. In the inner part of your thigh, you should be able to see your big toe. Keep breathing. Shoulders relaxed. Trying to get those hips squaring and shining forward, but in the beginning you might be shining to a corner. As you continue your yoga practice, you will get more flexible, I guarantee it, and you will feel so much better. And let's go into warrior two. Lunge a little bit deeper, pull back a little bit. Breathing into this. And let's go into reverse warrior. Into warrior two. Let's just get ready, prepare to go to side angle. So drop this elbow here, slide this hand up to your shoulder, then out over your ear. Nice, beautiful straight line. Lunge a little bit more into this. Open up a little bit more, trying to create a straight line from your leg all the way like that diagonal side angle. And then let's come out of this. We're going to be preparing to go into triangle. So shorten your stance. I'm going to turn as you can see me shorten your stance. Lift your arms up, and we're going to just our upper bicep, both legs are straight. Hinge forward, you're just reaching forward like this, just beautiful hinge. And then we're going to tick-tock down. So dropping that hand either to the leg or to the floor. And then let's imagine we have a clock here. Let's wind up our clock. Let's go the other way. Wind up this clock. Opening up this clock, just both legs are straight. Again, you can look down to the center or up, whatever is good for you. Notice some days through this I get dizzy or maybe I didn't eat enough, so then I always look down. It's more grounding. It is more challenging to look up. So depending upon where you are, do what you would like. And let's drop this arm that's in the sky down. Just kind of shift your hips a little bit and then raise the other arm up to the sky. Wind up that clock once or twice. Trying to stack, lift those shoulders up, trying to stack them against each other. Both legs are straight. And then let's release out of this, preparing to go into a crescent lunge. So pick your heel up off the back and slowly come up onto your thigh. And then just lunge into this a little bit more. Come into your heart center. Shift your weight forward. Raise those arms up to the sky. And arch back a little bit, feeling that stretch and that hip flexor and that psoas right all in here. And let's slowly come back here. You can drop to your knee if you want. Let's go into that twist. Shift your weight forward a little bit. And then everyone come back to the center. Lower down to your knee. Just hold here for a moment, finding that focal point, concentrating on your breath. Let's release down, place your hands on the mat. Let's turn this leg back and go into a one-legged down dog. And then let's lower this leg down. Let's just drop to our knees for a moment, getting ready to go into camel pose. So we're gonna just throw this in here in the middle of round two. So if you have a pillow or a towel, or you can fold your mat, you can put your towel here, or you can fold your mat down like this just for a little extra padding. So come onto your, if you need it. So you can make a fist with your hands and bring them even behind you. Just place them right here on your sacrum, or just have your hands pressing your sacrum out. Try to bring your hips in line with your knees. That's what's most important, this alignment. So you want to always be mindful of that. If you don't have any neck pain, you can drop back to here. So you can be right there and hold it, or if you want a little bit more advanced, you can drop back to your knees here. And then try to bring your hips in line with your knees. Bring them forward, and if you want, drop your neck back. come back up, lowering down, sliding your hands out of your thighs, all the way out to the front of your mat, and just rolling down. We're going to do that once more, so let's come back up, going to where you want to go. It is easier if you widen your stance here. So bringing your hands to where you want to bring them, and going back to where you want to go. Just remember to try to bring those hips back in line with your knees. Push them forward. And then let's slowly come all the way forward, sliding your hands down, stretching out here, resting your forehead. That just once more. Would you like to do that in a series of three? So come back up when you're ready, or just stay right where you were. Go to where you want to go. This is so good, because I always say we're such a forward-slumping society, so this is good to try to get some of these back bends and open up our chest and our spine, working on our posture, our flexibility. Okay, so let's slowly come back up onto all fours. If you have that towel or your mat, you can put it back to the side. So let's lift back up into down dog. Let's just come together. Let's do a few deep breaths here. Let's get ready. Let's take this leg, just lift it up, bend it in, and then lift. Come all the way forward. Pivot and flatten your back foot. Let's rise up. Rotating out, going into warrior one, lunging forward, arching back, breathing into this. Let's go into warrior two, lunging forward, pulling back. And then let's go into reverse warrior. Coming into that side angle pose. Now if you can, you can stay here, or you can take this arm and bring it behind, wrapping it around, trying to come around to your thigh, just opening this up, lunging in a little bit deeper. And let's release out of this. Let's come back up. Let's inhale our arms up to the sky as we twist, getting ready to go into pyramid. So you're square your hips, and if you have those headlights here, they'd be shining here, not to the side, straight ahead. And just hinge down so your hips say hello to your thigh. You can stay here, or you can drop all the way down. Drop your head down. Both legs are straight, breathing into this. Just release out of this, walk around, walk your arms around. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. So let's rise up, rotate our shoulders out and around. Flatten that back foot, the palm of that foot, roll that out onto the mat. So this part of your foot that's there, roll that out. And then inhale and come up and lunge into this arch back. Breathing into this. Bring it to warrior two. Lunging a little bit deeper, pulling back. Inhaling and exhaling through your nose. Let's go into reverse warrior. So you might be looking up or to the side or down, depending, listening to your body and what you need. And then from here, let's go right into side angle pose. So reaching out, this arm's going over your ear. Reaching out over your head, trying to open up a little bit more. And you can stay here, or if you want, bring this arm behind, a little bind. Try to wrap it around, getting it to your thigh. Look back, lunge a little deeper. And then let's slowly come out of this. You may need to shorten your stance a little bit. Squaring those hips, so everything's shining this way. Inhale up, we're going into pyramid, so we're just hinging down, hands to the thigh or to the floor. If you have blocks or books, that's great. Drop your head down here. Walk your arms out a little if you want to surrender to this pose. Keep breathing. So beautiful. Oh, it feels so good. Then let's slowly walk back around to the center. So you're going to just walk your arms down, just walk your arms and walk your feet out a little bit. And you can place your forearms on the mat if you can. If you can only come to here, that's okay. So lowering down to here, drop your head down. If you can, get your head to the mat. That's what we're trying to do. But if not, you're not there, that's okay. And just breathe into this. So I today feel this pulling a lot more on my left side and my hamstring in here a little bit. I don't feel anything on the other side. So just breathing into this. Now I want you to shift your weight a little bit forward so you feel some pressure on your head. And then back, just press back and just kind of notice how that feels, just that slight range of motion, how that feels. And then let's just bring our hands up. Let's just slowly come up a little bit. Drop that head back down and shift your weight forward. Just putting some weight on your head a little bit so you can see what that feels like. Good job. And then let's slowly come back up. Just walk your feet in a little bit if you need to. I was out quite a bit. And then let's take our right arm and wrap that around our ankle and just pull in here. And you can raise your arm up to the sky if you want. Let's come back down and let's switch sides. So walk over to the other side. So your left arm wraps around your right ankle. You might just stay here. Or if you want, let's open up to here. So like come back down, let's walk back around, coming back into down dog or one-legged down dog, your choice. Now let's have everyone in down dog, let's do one deep breath together. And then let's raise this left leg up and come up as high as you can. Come up on your toe, then open up this hip here, drop back down, come back up, just do that a couple times. And then flatten back down. Let's just make some circles here. And go the other way. Great, let's extend it back out. Square your hips. And then let's lower down. Let's go into a one-legged plank for a moment. Or you can be right here, or you can always be here. And then let's lower back down. Let's press back into down dog. Let's catch our breath together. Shorten your down dog stance if you need to. Sometimes we get a little bit too far out, so just play with different things, see what works for you, what feels better. Then let's raise this other leg up. Let's come all the way up on our toe. And then come back down. Let's do that again. A couple times. Then lower down. Let's bend this out with open. Press the weight through your hands. Just feel this opening up. Let's make a few little circles here. This should feel really good. Always listen to your body. If something doesn't feel good, just because the instructor's doing it doesn't mean you need to. Let's extend this leg back out, square your hips, and lower back down into down dog. And then let's come forward into that plank. Let's do a one-legged plank if we can. Shift the weight forward, lower those hips, or drop all the way down to here. Let's have everyone drop down. Let's go back into extended child's pose. And then let's come all the way forward onto our mat, all the way down, back to where we were earlier. So make sure you have room to move if you're moving. So let's have our hands right in tight towards our chest, feet behind. Okay, let's just lift up here, lifting back. Try to lift those hands up and squeeze those shoulder blades together. And then let's lower down. Do that again, come back up, squeeze those shoulder blades, and then lower down. Now we're going to add on to this. So we're going to extend our arms out straight. We're going to do a little lift and crunch. This is targeting that dreaded back flab. So you can use weights here. That's not the first time we do it. Let's not use weights. So everything out. First, we're just going to lift arm up, opposite arm to opposite leg. Let's just lift up. Keep your head parallel and looking down. into this. And then let's lower down. Then let's just lift up. We're flying over the world. Spread your arms out a little bit. And realize your head is down. Parallel. I don't want it up. Keep it here. Come back in. Let's go swimming here. And then let's release down for a moment. Resting your head to one side. Coming back to the center. Let's lift back up again. And let's go swimming. And then let's lower back down. We're going to lift up and go swimming again. So come back to the center. Lift up and go swimming. And let's lower down and rest for a moment. Now this time you can either add your legs and your arms together or just your arms. Let's start with our arms first. So our feet are flat behind. We're just lifting up and we're bringing our arms out like a beautiful brush stroke. Coming back and lowering down. Lift up and arms out. And come back and down. Now if you want, you can add your legs or you can just do your arms. So if you want to add your legs, it's like this. And lifting up. Let's just do two more of these. And let's lower down. And then we're going to do this also. This really targets that back leg. So you're going to do a punch. You're going to lift up. And you're punching up and coming back down. Switch sides. If you don't want to have to do your feet, you can just do your arms like this. Or you can add your feet. This is tough. Let's lower back down. Take a quick breath. Rest. We're going to do one more set of those because these are tough. Okay, here we go. Let's go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's lift up. Lift and punch. You got this. Come on, keep going. Whew, almost done. And then let's lower down. Great job. And then let's just slowly come back up onto the mat. So let's press up and go back into a down dog. So press and roll, lift all the way up, go right back into, not down dog, I'm sorry, extended child's pose. Extending all the way here, leaning into this. And then let's lift back up, let's come around on all fours, coming into a sit position on our mat. We're gonna get ready to go to plow and fish, and then we'll see what else we might add in. So extend one leg out, bend the other one in, and let's just roll down one vertebra at a time. So roll down all the way here. Once you're here, pull your legs into your chest. And rotate your, massage your low back. Great, let's release down. Make sure you have room left over. Let's extend our legs up to the sky. Extend your arms up to the sky. Just breathing into this. So you might stay here if you want, or if you want to go into an inversion. Then let's release our arms down and follow me. So we're gonna press and lift and roll all the way and lift up. Rolling back so we get our legs over. Imagine an apple under your chin. You can put your hands here for support. If you need to, you might need to walk out a little bit. Get those shoulders in a more comfortable position. And then from here, bring your legs together and slowly come up. Hands are on your low back for support as you walk your hands up. Imagine that apple under your chin. Try to walk up and try to get your legs a little bit straighter, higher. Toes point your legs straight, so you can stay here or you can play with this. Doing what you want to do in your inversion, and also mindful of the space you're in. You might not have room to go as free or crazy as you want to. So just going to where you can, doing what you want, using those hands for support. Really try to lift up a little bit more. Noticing how this feels. Then let's slowly come back down, lowering back down, all the way back down to the mat. Let's reach behind and grab one foot if we can, and the other one. And And let's bring those arms back down, placing them on the mat, and then that one vertebrae at a time, let's lower back down. Pull your legs in towards your chest for a little compression here. Just press everything into the mat so everything stabilizes. And then let's slowly release and go into fish. So lift up your bottom, sit on your hands. Extend your legs out straight. And then let's arch up as though there's a giant beach ball underneath our back. Lift up here so the weight is in your elbows and your head. Let's slowly release out of this. Let's inhale our arms above our head. Exhale those arms back down. Lift that bottom back up. Sit on your hands. Let's tuck our chin to our chest and lift our feet up. Let's go swimming here. Keep breathing. If this is too much to have your head up, you can always drop it to the mat. Now let's do crisscrosses. Toes pointed, legs straight. Crisscrosses here. And go into pulses. And let's go back to swimming. Lift up a little bit more. And back to crisscrosses. Legs straight. Keep breathing. Back to little pulses. Great job. And let's slowly release. Bring those legs back in towards your chest. Little gentle roll from one side to the other. Then let's extend one leg up and then the other. Reach your hands up. Let's go into dead bug pose or happy baby. So your palms and your feet are flat up towards the ceiling. You're pulling your knees down towards the floor. Just breathing into this. Extend our legs out straight into an upside down V. Make our back flat on the mat so our back is supported. You can either hold your big toes or you can hold your legs. Just go to where you can. And then let's slowly bring these legs back in. Tuck this in. Let's extend one leg out straight. Pull the other one in towards your chest. And then we're going to just take one hand underneath. The other hand is going to go out on the mat or on your hip. Let's put it out on the floor. And just roll over to one side into a spinal twist. So I want you, instead of focusing on getting the knee to the floor, readjust and try to have your shoulder blades flat on the mat. And then let's look the opposite way. Don't forget about that leg out straight, extend it out straight. Slowly come back to the center and release. So bring the other leg in, readjust your body. Pull this other leg in towards your chest. And then get ready and prepare for that spinal twist. So we're rolling over. And right now, let's readjust our shoulders, try to get those flat on the mat. Breathe into this, you can look the opposite way. Use your breath to go a little bit deeper. Your breath, you should feel your knees getting closer to the floor, your shoulders are getting closer to the floor. You're really using your breath to go into the pose deeper. Let's come back out. Let's just pull this leg back in. Let's extend our legs out long. Let's inhale our arms up over our head. Point your toes. On the exhale, let's flex our feet. Let's do that again. Inhale and point your toes. Reaching and stretching, and then on the exhale, point your toes one more time. And then let's come back, rest those hands right in our hip bones. Let your legs comfortably flop out to the side. Let's close our eyes, and let's do 5 deep breaths here. Shavasana, the best pose of the day. Just focus on your breath, nice deep breaths. going to come back within your fingers and toes. We're going to roll onto one side in the fetal position. Pull your knees in towards your chest. Do a couple breaths here. And then from here, we're going to slowly come up. And we're going to come into a sit position on our mat. Let's sit up nice and tall. Let's inhale our arms. Clasp your hands in your heart center. Let's do a trunk roll to each side. So nice, making a circle. That's trunk roll. So we're just doing that. Let's go one more. And let's switch sides. Coming back to the center. Inhale your arms up. Clasp your hands, come down. Let's do that two more times. Inhaling up. Nice, big, deep breaths. Inhaling through your nose. And exhaling down. So give yourself a big hug. You've worked your body mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me.
So this has been YogaShape. I'm so glad you joined us. If you're there, say hello. I can see that there's a couple people watching, so I'd love you to leave an emoji or a comment. If you enjoyed this, share with your friends. I am streaming from my house to yours every Saturday and Sunday at 9:30 Eastern Standard Time. I'm also uploading these to YouTube. And if you don't know, I am the founder of Yoga Fun Day. It is a yoga and wellness festival. We had to postpone it in Miami this year, but we are hoping to have a Yoga Fun Day in Miami in November as well as next March. So stay tuned for that info dropping soon. We're trying to solidify the dates. And if you are not on my channel on YouTube, it would be great if you would go over to YouTube, search Yoga Shape Method and like it, because I only have a couple subscribers and I'm moving the good videos over to there after we record them. So thank you so much from my house to yours. Have a great Memorial Day weekend. I might have a surprise video tomorrow. So if you're there, you might see me come live tomorrow morning. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.